if it's cold where you are, like it is here, I'm in the Chicago suburbs and temps are, gosh, like a right hovering around 0 degrees Fahrenheit, maybe even a little bit less than that, way less than that, and considering wind chill. If you're brave enough, you certainly can buy enough gear to allow you to run in these sort of temperatures. But I personally prefer to head just into the treadmill because frostbite is definitely something that can be of concern. So I wanted to hop on today and give some of my best tips for busting boredom when you're running on the treadmill. I used to do a lot more treadmill running than I do now. I've done my personal distance record on the treadmill is 18 miles. I was training for a marathon. And it really does take a while to get used to mentally running on the treadmill. Yes, and that's another good reason to get on the treadmill. Also for safety reasons, if you're in a new area and you just don't know the area well enough, it can be a lot safer to run on the treadmill than to run in an area you don't know is safe. And so really, the key to beating boredom on the treadmill is to find things to distract yourself mentally, because staying in place, just running for long periods of time is tough. I will let you know, the more you run on the treadmill, the easier it starts to feel mentally, because your mind gets used to sitting on a treadmill for, at first 30 minutes to 45 minutes, and then you'll be able to run an hour without, feeling like, you might just explode from boredom, and you'll be able to extend the length of your runs on the treadmill. So a lot of it is mental training. So learning those mental tools to get through. But a lot of it comes down to mixing things up for some people, setting up, if you have a TV, or now that we've all got smartphones and tablets, maybe watching a TV show on there. I used to have a series that I would love to watch, and I would only watch new episodes when I was on the treadmill, which helped also motivate me to get on the treadmill. Even like music, I don't always advocate listening to music while running outside. Yes, and podcasts are awesome too, books on tape, or digital audiobooks, I guess, is what people do these days. Just something to keep your mind interested. Those are all great. And what's nice about the treadmill is, again, you don't have to worry about keeping an eye on your surroundings, for traffic, other runners, that sort of thing, like you do outdoors. So it's totally safe generally, to run with headphones in and kind of zone out that way. And then, so those are things that you can do to mentally distract yourself, just kind of bringing along media, other things to kind of busy your mind. And then the other great things to do are to vary up your workouts. So doing slight speed intervals, or even if you want to do speed work on the treadmill, I love doing speed work on the treadmill. It's incredibly effective, and that's honestly my favorite way to do speed work. I know I can control my environment a lot more easily there. But even yeah, exactly. So speed the treadmill up, a tenth of a mile per hour, that sort of thing, or maybe 2/10, just a little bit, and then back it back down. So you still want to stay in your appropriate effort level. So you don't want to, crank it up to where you're huffing and puffing if it's supposed to be an easy run, but just varying it up a little bit. And so maybe speeding up just a tiny bit for 2 minutes, and then bringing the speed down a little bit for 2 minutes. So say if your base, you want to stay at a 6 mile an hour approximately pace, you could crank it up to 6.1 for 2 minutes, and then crank it down to 5.9 for 2 minutes. And just like the act of varying it can make it a little more interesting. You can do the same thing with incline. Put it at a 0.5% or a 1% incline for a minute or two, and then crank it back down. And just the act of, paying attention to changing even tiny little intervals like that, where your effort is pretty much the same, it just keeps your mind busy and it can make the miles go by a lot faster. So those are my big tips, or what I've personally used to help me get through my treadmill runs.